So, hey, first of all, Rocco, did you ever feel unsafe or anything during that time? Are you going to be doing anything like this anytime soon?
No. Hey, everybody. Welcome to today's vlog. This is a special one. So, as you can see, Rocco's, like, tired. I'm going to kind of do this intro because I would say this vlog's more about me today than Rocco. For all of you who aren't in California or aren't aware of what's going on, we released our Orbeez in the back of the truck video where we drove Rocco around for about 5 minutes on some streets in the truck. So that got reported to the police. They showed up at our house this week. They gave us some tickets. But yesterday on California's all the news channels, it was reported that I was arrested and that I'm in big trouble. And, you know, just, it's all bad. Anyway, Rock is tired, I'm tired, because since 8 o'clock this morning, we have been doing news interviews. We have hit 4 news channels. We've done other shows like Inside Edition. We've got contacted by some other media networks to do other shows talking about our YouTube and why we did what we did and what it's all about. And if Rock was having fun or just they want to know more about us now. So anyway, I just want to take this time to say to people, like, in California, it is illegal to have Rocco in the back of the truck and be driving. So I broke a law, and for that, I'm going to pay the price. I'm guilty. I cooperated with the police. It was a very easy, open-shut case. We have our tickets and all that. Never were we detained, arrested, handcuffed, or put in jail. That didn't happen. We admitted guilt that we made a poor 5-minute bad parenting judgment to drive around with him in the back. So anyway, if you all know us, you know that we protect this kid from everything, right? We make sure you're safe and you have fun. Do you like YouTubing? So anyway, we're going to show you a clip today of our hectic morning of doing all these news interviews. We had people lined up at our door to get us on camera. So anyway, for all you parents who are deeply offended by the fact of Rocco being in the back of the truck, I'm sorry. I never meant to offend anybody or cause all this chaos. I mean, we've learned our lesson, right? So we were just looking for 5 minutes of fun, taking Rocco outside, being adventurous, and all that stuff. And unfortunately, kids can get hurt any which way these days. So, you know, but we did break a law, and we're sorry for that, or I'm sorry for that.
I am tired. I've done four.
So anyway, I hope you guys keep watching, keep subscribing. We're not stupid. We're not idiots, like all the comments say. We're not bad parents. We just, for 5 minutes, decided to have a little fun. Probably wasn't the best thing to do. So anyway, we hope you guys enjoy watching all the news channels at our house today and everything. And then we will be back tomorrow with a bunch more of craziness of Rocco's life. So anyway, thanks a bunch for all your support and views, and we will see you tomorrow. We out.
Sensation,
right?
Yeah.
This is who all the fuss is over. All in one piece, safe and sound, educated, well-mannered kid.
And this is your son?
Yes.
Okay.
That's my son, yeah. Okay.
We just go stand out front?
Sure. As long as you don't.
And do any, you none of you guys mind being on our video, right?
You do whatever you
okay.
want.
Okay. Just making sure.
So yeah, we're just doing that stuff right now, but yeah, it's pretty crazy that we just thought it would just go pretty viral on YouTube. Now we've got cops showing up at our house, news channels, and it's kind of crazy at this point right now, but it's really fun to see how it's going.
Okay, you're 8 and you're Rocco. What's your last name?
Piazza.
It's Piazza or Piazza?
Piazza, yes. So yeah, I mean, you all know our YouTube channel. But then we went up on the back streets and cul-de-sacs. Like, if you watch the rest of the video, we are literally crawling at slow speeds.
Yeah.
We have to show up in court for not having him restrained. That. And then we, because the Orbeez dumped it out.
Yeah, clean that up.
Right, so because they said they were slippery, so we got a ticket for littering. So,
when did the video post?
Monday.
Monday.
And we did it on Friday, right?
Yeah.
So we shot it on Friday. They brought their cleanup crew to clean up the street on Monday. They were really nice and cooperative, and they just said, basically, they just were like, you're taking all the fun out of this. We wanted you to put up a fight and tell us that you're in the right. And I'm like, well, no. There's a law that says they can't be in the back of the truck. I broke it.
Okay. Rocco, we need to upgrade our cameras. We're slacking.
Glad nothing
he's
bad
safe
happened.
And sound. Thank you. And I'm glad you let us talk before airing.
Notes it said that the post from Corona came 5 hours prior. So that my guess would have been 5 o'clock.
Look at you.
You know what was funny? I was so excited to hear from Kim today because last night when I was going to bed, this is what I said. I said, you know what? I hope we get contacted by a news show or a talk show because it's time for people to know the truth about YouTube, that we don't exploit children. We're not treating him wrong or doing anything against his will. YouTube's the new way of life. Yeah. It's for kids this age and my daughter's age, this is their TV. You know what I mean? And parents right now are so, they don't understand it. They're so turned off by it. It's funny. They don't understand that this is no different than
TV.
Than kids doing television and, hey, we match.
Nice, twinsies.
I know you guys have been doing a ton of interviews.
It's okay.
No, but I'm saying, so with this one, it's going to be very similar. I just like to have a conversation. We'll talk about what happened. Kind of, you can explain everything. You can even go into the whole thing about YouTube and being away. And you please also say how the only thing I did wrong was I didn't have him restrained.
Right.
I'll ask you a few questions, Rocco. I'm sure you're used to this now, right?
Yeah.
I can talk about
it. Oh, well, that starts it. So if I say, how long have I been doing YouTube? You say, well, I've been doing YouTube for X.
Yeah.
So first thing's always the hardest. I need your first and last name on camera. We'll start with you, Holly. You can just say and spell it for us.
You want whole name or just first name?
Yeah. Rise of the interest that was happening. How did it come about? I mean, you had your first 100 followers. You're like, wow. But then it's 1,000. And now you're up to over a million.
We wake up every day are you serious? Are we really YouTubers?
Yeah. Right? It's just crazy. We just started out as a joke and then now it's turned into our daily job, so it's really cool though. But
now, Holly, let me ask you. So you put out these videos daily and then this thing, the incident happened from yesterday. Do you feel like your daily life is under more scrutiny now because the incident has happened? How do you be able to put it all together?
Well, with YouTube, it gives people the freedom to comment all day long on our videos. So for the last year, we've dealt with comments, be it positive or negative, but being in this, being on this YouTube platform, you have to, as a parent, kind of not read them, ignore them. This one caught me by surprise, most definitely, because we never put Rocco in harm's way. He wears protective gear.
Yeah.
We make sure he's safe. And although I did, as a parent, choose to break the law of letting him be in the back of a truck. I knew that day I was in control. What you see in the video, I think, doesn't depict the safety measures we took. We went way off of busy streets. So it's a choice that we've made. I know that I keep my kids safe. I know that Rocco is well cared for and that Rocco's doing this by his choice. We have always told Rocco, if you don't want to do this anymore, if it's not fun, or you don't like being in the public eye, we can stop. Or if you don't want to do this idea because you don't feel safe about it or you don't like it, we don't have to do it. What we do is just fun entertainment, and we would never ever let him get injured on the way. We're not going to stop YouTubing because of this, and the comments are going to keep coming, but we had just as much of support as in what we did as we did negative comments. So basically the officers came on Tuesday of this week just to get our side of the story. They said they'd received some calls. Some people wanted action taken. 10-minute conversation telling them what we did. They explained that, they were going to finish the investigation and be back with us. Then yesterday around 9 a.m., the officers showed back up at the house They gave us a cite and release ticket. That's all they did. Nobody was detained, nobody was handcuffed, nobody was arrested or taken away. It was a 5-minute conversation with the officer. We signed that we're aware of our court date and that if the DA chooses, they could prosecute. No, it's not smart to video yourself and breaking the law and then put it on TV, you know, on. But it happens a lot. We know that we've been told by other YouTubers, they're policing YouTube now. Because if you know me and you know this family, you know that we take responsibility for our actions. We're good people. At this point, it's gotten so much attention. I think, yes, we are going to do a video letting our followers and other people on YouTube know that, hey, don't do anything reckless or stupid. You know, we're sorry that, you know, I made this choice. The thing about YouTube, I think that a lot of people don't know that as a parent, I want to express, like, I know it because... But this young generation, this is their new television. This is what they watch. Kids don't sit in front of the TV anymore. They sit in front of, you know, mobile devices, iPads, phones, computers, and they watch on-demand entertainment.
People just comment down below like, you're just like sacrificing this kid. Why are you doing this to him? Well, with every video, it's almost always my ideas or their ideas. And I always make the choice if I want to do it. And if I want to do it, I'll do it. If I don't feel comfortable doing something in the video, I won't do it. And I'll tell someone if I don't want to.
Looking back on the whole experience, all this attention, would you do it again?
Well, of course, we're not going to do it again. It's against the law. We learned our lesson. We're definitely not going to take this with a grain of salt. What bothers me probably the most is... I was raised in the back of a truck. I grew up on a farm, you know. I go out to Glamis where the deserts and the dunes are. I see people in pickup trucks all the time with their kids out there. Are they filming it? No, not for public to view, but it still goes on. So we know we're not the only people out there that do things with our children that probably aren't the safest at all times. But I guess what I would have to say is I just want people to understand we don't exploit Rocco. We don't put him in harm's way. There's a lot of stuff I've put my foot down to doing that I refuse to do or be involved with because of safety issues. But this particular incident, like I said, the video, you know, can be very deceiving. The media can be very deceiving. But we're very average Joe house. We follow rules. We teach manners and we teach him to be polite and respectful and educate him. We just have fun an hour each day and we put it up for people to enjoy.
Yeah, I think it was an awesome time with the Orbeez, and I love to always think about positive, even if there's a negative side. So, yeah.
24 News is gonna pull up now.
You're famous, bro.
My hair look good?
Yes, it does.
All right.
I'm not used to the camera. I don't ever.
You're on the opposite side.
Oh, I was in shock last night. We started getting texts and calls from family and friends, like saying, "What the heck? You were arrested!" It came as much of a surprise to me as it did everybody else. And our channel does a lot of good too. Like we donate for children's toy drives. We donate to cancer foundations. We do a lot. He's a good kid. And you know he's got his future secured for him right now.
So hey, first of all, Rocco, did you ever feel unsafe or anything during that time?
Well, I didn't really feel unsafe at all. I mean, you were just kind of like trapped in there, and I would kind of just go side to side. But I felt comfortable enough, and it was good for me. So I mean, I felt safe.
You had a lot of fun, didn't you?
Yeah.
You know, they always say that kids always learn a lesson as they grow older. Are you kind of glad that you guys now know that there are certain limits to doing this kind of stuff?
Yeah, I'm really glad that we know what, that we know, like, I really respect all the rules in this world, like, and even if there's a positive side to it, I always love to think about the positive side instead of the negative side, because, I mean, I don't really like negative, so I just always go to positive.
Are you going to be doing anything like this anytime soon?
No.